What's up, dudes? Welcome back. Today we have a little bit more on the diamond grind. We continue with a little bit of the series to help you guys get your dark matter and diamond and gold camos done. And you guys said the Man O' War was the gun you wanted to see. I'm actually going to use Elo. But this is the class I usually use, which is Elo, Rapid Fire, High Caliber, Stock. And then I'm using Hardwired Dead Silence Awareness because I play Search a lot. But if you're playing Respawn, you probably don't need all of these. You can use them. A lot of people do use this stuff in Respawn. But you can also get away with using Fast Hands. I really wouldn't suggest Scavenger, maybe? I mean, Man of War is one of those guns that has a slow rate of fire but kills people very quickly. So having a slow rate of fire means you don't burn through ammo too fast. You're able to kill a lot of people before you're actually out of ammo. So Scavenger might not be the best choice. Fast Hands is pretty good. You can, of course, rock stuns or frags if you would prefer to rock only one perk three. Totally up to you on that one, but this is the class that I've been using. Specialist, I'm using Heatwave just so if I get close to someone, I can Heatwave and then get a single headshot. It just makes it a little bit easier. And then if you're going specifically for headshots, UAV, Counter UAV, and Hater are pretty good. If you're going for Bloodthirsties, this also works for a good combo, but if you're going for long shots, you can use pretty much whatever you want. The only thing that I would say is if you're going for long shots, play hardcore. Long shots are almost always easier in hardcore. I know a lot of people don't like hardcore. I mean, just look at the player base. 21% of people are in hardcore. So a majority, 75-80% of people don't like hardcore, don't play it. But it will make your life a lot easier, especially for certain weapons. All right, that covers it though. We're going to play a little bit of Search. I'm going to talk about the gun and how to play it effectively or play with it effectively. And we'll go from there. All right, we're good to go. We got the Man of War here on Splash. And I'm probably going to try to play this gun to its advantage here. It's always good to do that. This is more of a mid-range rifle. It's not great in the long range. It's not bad, but with the high rate of recoil and the low rate of fire, it makes it kind of hard to shoot super long distance. So it can excel in a distance like this, but if I'm going really, really far, it may not work. All right, I'm going to back up. I do have rapid fire on the gun, though, to give me a little bit better of a chance of getting the close range gunfights, but it does not guarantee me anything. He's hit twice, so he's one shot. Oh, one more back there. He'll get him, though, hopefully. There's a third. Wow, they're all over in this frickin' house. Good lord. Now, for those of you that don't know, the Man of War is a three-shot kill at almost any range, I believe. It is a two-shot kill if you hit the headshot, so you can go headshot body to kill, or you can do body headshot. Both of those will result in a two-shot kill. This is a really good gun in multiplayer in Respawn, but in Search, it's not the greatest, and the reason for that is Search is a game mode that it relies heavily on picking people off. We'll say that. So you see guns like the XR2 and the M8 and the Shiva excel in a game mode like this. But when you're playing Respawn, the ability to not burn through too much ammo and kill a lot of people is a huge benefit that the Man of War has that not other guns may have. Just murdered two really quick there. And that's a really good range for this gun. Like that range right there is acceptable, but super, super long range, you will notice that this thing will struggle. Little kick up right there is not too shabby though. I will take that solid two shot, no problem. I'm gonna go back to their spawn though to see if I can find any. Well, one behind me? No. He's shooting crossbows at my guy over there. Gotta be a little sneaky here. I don't want Mr. Crossbow to kill me. There we go. Is he up here with him too? Well, I don't want my teammate to stand next to me. So I will let him go. It's best we both don't die at the exact same time, you know? I'm thinking he's back into spawn. I mean, they usually sit back there. So let me just take a look here. Check the corner here. This is a good spot usually. Yep. That's where they usually sit, in the corner, in the bushes. That's an average Call of Duty player right there. All right, we're back. I feel like after that teammate, I might want to mention that if you struggle playing any form of Respawn team game mode, playing solo is not a bad deal. A lot of people I know played free-for-all to do their headshots, because in free-for-all you get a few kills each game, 30 kills you can get to, but you can get probably, 5, 10, 15 headshots, and you also don't have to worry about having good, bad teammates, which is a big, big plus. In my opinion, it's a big plus. There's a few right there. I don't know where the last guy might be. Is he in the far, far, far back? Yes, he is. There's another headshot really quick. That rapid fire almost helps kick the shots up into the head, because it does have a good, you know, a good recoil. It's like, I mean, it is vertical. It's straight up and down, which is nice, but it has a good amount of recoil, what I'm trying to say. Ding! Headshot. But Free For All is not a bad game mode to play if you're going for headshots. I mean, I didn't do it, but just because I didn't do it doesn't mean it's bad. I give you guys my best guess on what will help you, on based off of my experience, the people that I know, what I've seen, and I've played a lot, so I mean, you can trust me that, you know, I have like 14 days played now. I have pretty much everything unlocked in the game that I've been going for. I'm still working on 100% completion for challenges because I figured why not. But there are a lot of things that I've done in the game, so I do try to give you guys my feedback and experience based off of that. I feel like that's going to help you the most. Unfortunately, my team did not want to arm the bomb. That kind of sucks. If he gets on that Heglitch right there, he's going to destroy me. I have my whole team running around loud without Dead Silence. If you're playing Search, man, use Dead Silence. I've mentioned this so many times, but it is so important. I feel like, I don't know why people don't understand that. Maybe they don't own headsets, but even if you don't own a headset, everyone else, like, does, you know? So, if you don't have one, it sucks, I'm sorry, but a lot of other people do. And you are going to have to deal with it. I'm gonna let them all go past me. Because I'm not a big fan of, all those people there. They're just really loud. 12-1's not bad. This map was pretty good for this gun. It does keep people within the sight lines, or within the range, I should say. With decent sight lines of the ranges that there are. To this weapon's, you know, ability. If it was longer, like, what's a good map example for that? Probably Evac. Evac has a few sight lines that are just too long for this gun. And the M8 will beat you almost every time, unless you are really good at bursting the weapon. But that's why this gun is so good in respawn, is because you don't need to burst the weapon. A lot of the gunfights you get into are in the mid or close range, and you don't have to reload much because it's 3 shots to kill. You can go through 10 people before you reload, if you have perfect accuracy. Well, it looks like my team really wanted to play Splash again. I'm not against it. We didn't do bad, but I would have liked a different map to try to, you know, point out the sight lines that are too hard for this to hit. Maybe like a good example is like right here. Like if I post up right here, I'll most likely die. I'll just do it to test it. If I can kill the guy, maybe, but usually snipers go up there. I did get the first shot, which was pretty good. He backed down. But that sight line is just a bit too hard to hit. The recoil is too much, you know? That's what I was trying to illustrate. Two. Three. Where's the fourth? No fourth. Okay, well, I tried. I was like, I'd like to hit the quad, but that'd be cool. Where's bomb guy? He's moving up on B. One's in the back of the spawn with the sniper. I'll let him chill there. Got one in blue. There's only one alive. It's just a sniper, but this guy just refuses to arm the bomb. More teammates that don't play the objective. Ugh! Peoples, come on. You gotta learn. Gotta learn. The objective. It matters.
Bomb active.
That guy's loud. I don't like this. Oh, he got him now. I was so sketch, man. I didn't like that teammate. When people walk around me without Dead Silence, I'm automatically freaking out. Like, it fucking scares me. Because I can't hear anything. Because all I can hear is them. And then opponents can hear them, in which case they find me next to them and they kill me. So, usually it results in a bad deal. Not every time, but usually. Alright, I'm gonna try a route. I went through pool one round, which is pretty good. I'm gonna go straight B-side and see if that works out at all. I usually don't do this because it is I'm at a disadvantage here if I go this way. But I'm gonna give it a shot regardless. I mean, what's worse that happens? I die? Ooh, I did outgun that guy there. That guy was, I don't know what he was thinking. His teammate didn't kill me. Let me just push up a little bit. There's one right there, I can see him. He's jumping up and down. Let me just crouch up all the way here. Get on this head glitch. Ninja status, bros. Ninja status. Alright, let's go up. Oh my god, just outgunned them both. Holy shit. The melt factor. The 3-shot melt factor. Good lord. That was quick. I can't believe this is working so well. In honesty, I usually record these, and I don't expect a lot. I mean, I try to do as good as I can, but I know the limitations of guns. And this gun right now is overperforming where it shouldn't. Like, this was an M8 and a VMP that I just killed. With, I mean, the Man of War is a great gun, like I said. It's a really good respawn gun. But when it comes to search, it normally does not perform this well. I expect the gun to hold its own, you know, like it can, I'd probably get like a 2.5, 3 KD maybe. But 7-0 is overperformance in my opinion. I would not expect this much from this weapon. It's just not one of those guns that picks people off. It's not a bad weapon. I do like it, but I'm a little taken back by how effective it is being currently, even though I'm putting it on sight lines that it usually does not succeed on, like purposefully, you know? I'm not doing it by accident. I did it on purpose. Coming into this sight line right here is a bad deal. Usually you lose that gunfight really quickly, especially to snipers. Now on something like this close, I will win the gunfight. All right, he walked down. I gotta buy some time here. UAV online team. It's all on me. Well, we'll see if I can do it. The bomb has been planted. That'll make it a lot harder for him. I assure you of that. We'll just throw that there and we'll just chill back here, I think. Murdered him. Murdered him. 15 shots. I don't have to reload, but I will just in case. I have time. This gun can get a lot of kills. It doesn't need to be reloaded with 15 shots left. I did burn my sentry this round, but I felt like it was a necessary thing to do. He's coming up right now. I'll get the plus 200 here. Or I'll just let him go at the sentry. And the sentry will get him. It's okay. That works. That works okay. I was going to wait till the bomb blew up and then kill him for plus 200 instead of plus 100. Get more score. Just because it helps me get toward my next streak. But it's not a bad deal. That dude went all the way on the water. Good lord. He was out there fucking just looking for fish or something. Yeah, I know. We don't put fish in pools. But it'd be way cooler if we did. Okay. Swim with the fishies would be actually accurate. Okay, I think I'm going to avoid the beach this time. I'm going to go top A where I did the first round the last game. Because if I get inside the house, I do have heat wave, and that gives me an advantage, you know? The beach itself is pretty open as well, and I have a predator missile, or hellstorm. I like calling it predator missiles, but you know, whatever, hellstorm. So this does help me. I did not lay down the way I wanted to there, but okay. And there goes three of them. Alright. He looks like he was down in middle for a second there. Don't know if he's still here or not, but I'm gonna check. Does not look like it. There was one in middle. He killed my teammate there. He's going beach right now. There he is. There we go. Nothing there on the head glitch. Looks like we're okay now. Oh, he dropped him, but they got him. Not a bad game. That's a pretty good game, actually. 16-0-4 is pretty good. That means I averaged 4 kills a round and we won in 4. That is not bad. Okay, I'll take it. That was two pretty damn good games back to back with the Man of War. You know, that's... It does show the gun is pretty good. I think, you know, if you do play respawn with it, I think you'll have more success, in honesty. I think it really does well in respawn, where in comparison to search, this gun kind of overperformed the last few games. It normally doesn't do that good, especially if you have a lot of people you're playing against that are using M8s or just really strong weapons that pick people off. But nonetheless, it was really fun to play with that on Splash. It worked very well. Hope you guys enjoyed, though. I hope this covers the Man of War. If you do have questions, of course, you can leave a comment. And also suggest the next gun for the Diamond Grind, and I will hopefully do that one next. Thank you for watching.